Hello, Seiiti Arata. If you feel as though you're having difficulty learning, it could be that your brain is operating with the wrong brain waves in a way that is not ideal for studying. Today I'm going to be teaching you a small adjustment that you can do to get into the right state of mind where you can learn more and you can learn better. There are five categories of brain waves: alpha, beta, gamma, delta, and theta. You spend most of your time in the beta state. But it is in the alpha state, the alpha wave, that your brain will get into the right state for you to be reading and studying. The electrical activity emanating from your brain is displayed in the form of brain waves. And you have to learn how to tune these waves. Your brain works with synapses between billions of neurons in your head. All the scientific sources, all the context of the information that I'll be summarizing here for you, you can see in our Intelligence Arata Academy training that you can learn more about at arata.se/intelligence. And when your synapses are firing in sync, they create unified combinations of neurons marching like a harmonized neural network. This neural network is linked to a specific state of consciousness corresponding to your thoughts and your emotional state. It is this combination of synchronized electrical activity in the brain that the scientists call a brainwave. It is named like this because of its cyclical nature, resembling an ocean wave. And this wave movement has been observed thanks to medical equipment, such as the electroencephalogram, which measures the fluctuation of electricity levels in different areas of the head. And with this equipment, and also a lot of study, scientists discovered the five categories of brain waves, and they also found the right one that is the best for you to study, to learn more. Each brain wave category corresponds to a mental state. The secret of learning is to put yourself in the right frame of mind to study. The five categories of brain waves are classified according to their frequencies. For example, gamma waves oscillate around 40 cycles per second. They're also related to a higher state of conscious awareness when you process information from different areas of the brain simultaneously. Beta waves happen when your brain is stimulated, creating an agitated state of mind. For example, if you're giving a presentation or if you're speaking in public, the beta frequency ranges from 15 to 40 cycles per second. Now, the next category is alpha waves. You can understand alpha waves as the opposed to beta waves. If beta waves represent excitation, alpha waves represent non-excitation. Alpha brain waves are slower. They're wider. You know when you finish a job, then you sit down to rest, to relax, or when you take a day off and you go out for a walk? In these situations, your brain is in alpha. This is the state of mind it should be when you're studying. After the alpha waves, there are also the theta waves, which are very slow. They're associated with an even more positive state of mind. Then there are the delta waves, which occur when you are in a deep sleep state. So just to be clear, when you read before going to bed, the chances are you are in low beta. When you put your book down, you turn off the lights, close your eyes, your brain waves will descend from beta to alpha to theta. And finally, when you sleep, you reach delta. You spend most of your time in a beta state. But when you're studying, the ideal thing is to enter the alpha state. Your brain operates in a beta state during most of your waking time, when you're moving around, when you're doing your tasks, when you're dealing with everyday life. In a beta state, your brain is super engaged with rapid mental activity, so you can complete all the things you have to do. You're also operating in beta state when you start to worry, when you are unable to get out of a negative state of mind. Now, the problem is that it is very difficult to study when our brain is using beta waves. If you sit down to study and your brain is operating at full speed, your learning is not going to be optimized. Before starting your studies, you should ideally put yourself in an alpha state. You know when you get that feeling of peace and well-being? That's the alpha state, when you're calm, lucid, when you're fully aware of the present moment. The alpha state is the best state for you to be reading, studying, and learning. As brain activity is lower, you have fewer thoughts to be distracting you. This makes you study even more productive, more enjoyable. In this moment, when you're studying for a test, try to remain in an alpha state when you're taking tests as well. After all, It's always easier for you to remember the information that you have studied when you are in the same context, same wavelength, when you first learned it. To get into the alpha state, you need to slow down. You have to focus on the present moment. Okay, now you understand that the alpha state is the ideal brain's mental state for you to be studying, to learn. And the question that arises now is the following. How do I change? How do I put myself into the alpha state? It is all a matter of practice to reduce your speed, to increase your attention. Remember that you want to avoid the beta state, the state of fast, distracted, sometimes pessimistic brain activity, of trying to do and think of a thousand things at once. The alpha state, which you want to achieve, is the state of slower, focused, light brain activity. Any activity that gets you into that more positive state of mind will help you to get to the alpha state. For some people, what works is walking outside, listening to some calm music, drinking a cup of tea or some caffeine-free drink, doing some yoga, breathing calmly. Among all the activities, the one that has been proven to have more benefits, proven by science, is meditation. However, meditation doesn't work like magic overnight. You need to maintain a long-term practice to reap the results. The truth is that there is no one rule that works for everyone. To enter the alpha state, it is important that you avoid stimuli that speed up your brain, that you have to seek stimuli that slow down your brain waves. For example, avoid coffee, soda, opt for non-caffeinated tea, another beverage with theanine. You can avoid loud music and noisy places. Choose calmer music and a quiet place. And right before studying, avoid vigorous physical activity and prefer something more relaxing. That doesn't mean you should eliminate forever coffee from your life or running or intense music. Just leave these stimulating activities for the moments when you're further away from your study schedule. By doing so, you put yourself in a more conductive frame of mind so you can study and finally absorb the concepts, the study, the subjects that you have so much trouble learning about. Our brain operates in five different wave categories. We spend most of our time in the beta waves. But when we have to study, when we want to learn something, the ideal thing is to enter the alpha state. In the alpha state, your thoughts are slower and you can become more attentive. Thus, you can absorb whatever it is that you're studying much better, making you a smarter person. But this is not the only way to increase your intelligence levels. To learn all the proven techniques, I invite you now to see the intelligence training by going to arata.se/intelligence.